Very good morning, students. Welcome back to my channel. In the last class, we had discussed about the while loop, right? The first program is what? To find, to print first n natural numbers, or we are taken to print 1 to 10 natural numbers using while loop. Students, while loop, we are also called as pre-tested looping statement. So today, we are discussing the second program of while loop. The second program I will take as write an algorithm and flowchart to find sum of first five natural numbers using while loop. Define sum of first five natural numbers using while loop. In the last class, we have displayed 1 to 10 natural numbers. Here we have find out sum. Sum means the total value of first five natural numbers. So what is the definition of this problem? We have taken five natural numbers. The natural numbers begins with 1. And it is ends with 5 because in the problem they are given first 5 natural numbers. We are finding out the sum of these numbers. So what is the sum? So here we are taken 5, 4 plus 1, 10, then 3 plus 2 is 15. Total value or sum of these numbers is 15. This value we want to display in the algorithm and flowchart. So, we are developing an algorithm using a step-by-step procedure. The first step in the algorithm is dot. The second step here, we are not read the input variable because already they are given the value. First five natural numbers sum. So, that's why in the second step we are initialize. I value is 1. Why we are taking high value is 1? The first natural number we are initialized to variable high and sum value is 0. Initially we are initialized sum value is 0 because we are having any number with 0, we get the first number. First number is 0, so the hard part. Then first number is 0. So first number is second number is third number is fourth number. Fifth number is add madodike sari hogutte adikosthu naavu sum ge initial value 0 na initialize maadtidivi. Here we are taking values set I equals to 1, sum equals to 0. So this is called as a comment statement. Just for our understanding purpose I will write statement. Next step 3, here we are using while loop, right? Repeat step 4 and 5 until I less than or equal to 5. I less than or equal to 5 aagoorku nimge step 4 matte 5 repeat aagi execute aagbeku anta helthe. Then what is step 4? Step 4 we are given as sum equals to sum plus I. We are adding 0 with the first natural number. Next, the sum value we are adding with the next natural number. Like that, we are adding. So that's why we are writing the statement sum equals to sum plus I. Next statement, step 5. We are increase I value by 1 unit, right? Because we go for the next element. I equals to I plus 1. We are increase only 1 unit. Next here, end of step 3 while loop. End of step 3 while loop. Next step 6. Here we are not display the output. Just we are writing calculation statements. Finally, once we are display the output. Sum of first 5 natural numbers. First five natural numbers equals to which variable contains the sum? The variable is sum. We are interested at variable value. Next, last step is stop. See students, this is the algorithm we are implement for the find sum of first five natural numbers using while loop. While loop means it will check the condition first, then only it will execute its statements. If the condition is true, then only execute the statements. If the condition is false, it will come out of the while loop and execute the next statements in the program. Are you clear? Now, I will write the flowchart. The flowchart starts with oval. Start we are written using oval symbol. Next, there is no input statement. Initialization statement. I equals to 1, sum equals to 0. Next, we are given the condition. If means is I less than or equal to n. Sorry. The final value 5. The condition is true. We will find sum equals to sum plus I, then I equals to I plus 1. Both are calculation statement, that's why we are written in a single box. Next, this statement will be repeatedly executed until unless the while loop will be false. If the condition is false, it will come out of the while loop. Here there is no connection. We have displayed the output using parallelogram symbol. Output sum of first five natural numbers is, the variable name is sum. So the task is finished. We have stopped the flowchart using oval symbol. Are you clear? The algorithm and flowchart. So now, how this algorithm and flowchart will be executed, I will explain with the example values. In the exam, students, if they are asked to write an algorithm, just you write the algorithm. If they are asked to write the flowchart, write the flowchart. No need to write the outputs in the exam. ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕಾಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಆದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇದು ಯಾವ ತರ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ತಗೊಳ್ತೀನಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ಆಗ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ಆದ್ರೆ ಆ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ನೀವು ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೂ ಬರೆಯುವಂತ ನೆಸೆಸಿಟಿ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ನಾವ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಹೌ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಹೌ ದ ಫ್ಲೋ ಚಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಲ್ಗಾರಿದಮ್ ಬೋತ್ ಆರ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್. ಎನಿವನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಹಿಯರ್? ಯು ಆರ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ದ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಹೈ ಇಸ್ 1. What is the sum value? Sum value is 0. What is the sum value? Sum value is 0. Now, it will check the condition. I less than or equal to 5. What is the value of 5? 1. 1 is less than or equal to 5. Condition is what? 1 5 is less than 0. True. ಯಾವ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಡೇಟಾ ಈ ಸಿಂಬಲ್ ಗೆ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ಎರಡು ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ? ಸಮ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಸಮ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಹೈ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ ಸಮ್ ಐ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇದೆ? 1 ಇದೆ. ಸಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇದೆ? 0 ಇದೆ. 0 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 1 ಆಯ್ತು. ಸೊ 0 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 1 ಯಾವ್ದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಆಯ್ತು? ಸಮ್. ಸಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ 0 ಇತ್ತು, ಆದ್ರೆ ನ್ಯೂ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಅಪ್ಡೇಟ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಓಲ್ಡ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. 1 ಈಸ್ ರೀಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ 0. ಓಕೆನಾ? ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಹೈ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಬೈ 1 ಯೂನಿಟ್, ರೈಟ್? ಐ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಹೈ ಪ್ಲಸ್ 1 ಆಯ್ತು. ಸೊ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ ಹೈ 1 ಇತ್ತು, ಈಗ 1 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 1 ಏನಾಯ್ತು? 2 ಆಯ್ತು. ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ 2 ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಚೆಕ್ ದ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್. 2 ಈಸ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಆರ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 5. ಮತ್ತೆ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಟ್ರೂ ಆಯ್ತು, 2 डेटा वापस होते मत हई वालू चेक हई वालू टू इतना टू फैंत कड़म इतना सर स्टेटमेंट सम इक्वल्स टू सम प्लस हायर सो इल्ली अपडेटेड वैल्यू सम वन अपडेटेड वैल्यू ऑफ हाई इज टू नेक्स्ट वन प्लस टू इज थ्री नाउ द न्यू वैल्यू इज रिप्लेस द होल्ड वैल्यू सम कंटेन्स थ्री वैल्यू अगेन वी आर रिटर्न हाई इक्वल्स टू हाई प्लस वन स्टेटमेंट हाई प्लस वन हाई वैल्यू टू इतना टू प्लस वन थ्री आयु Using three value, the data is flowed to check the condition. So three less than or equal to five. Three less than five, if the condition is condition you true high, so again it will execute the statement sum equals to sum plus high. So sum value last situation on three there. If the high value is there three there. So three plus three is equal to six. Six value is replace the whole value of three. बरी सिक्स थ्री नेक्स्ट आई वैल्यू हमें ऐन
Right. So here the do while
we are also called as post-tested looping statement. Do while we are also called as post-tested looping statement. Do while we are also called as post-tested looping statement. Again, this is very important. In the examination, they are asked one more question. Which statement we are called as a post-tested looping statement? Answer is do while statement. Or they are asked a question. So, what is another name of do while statement? Your answer is post-tested looping statement. So, why it is called as a post-tested looping statement? The name indicates do. First, it will execute its statements once. Why? Then it will check the condition. First, it will execute its statements once before checking the condition. It will not check the condition first. It will execute the statements once. Later, it will check the condition. After execute the statements once, it will check the condition. So, that's why it is called as a post-tested looping statement. ಯಾಕೆ ನಾವು ಡು ವೈಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಲೂಪಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ ವರ್ಡ್ ಡು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ ಯು ಡೂ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಯು ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ ಡು ವೈಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಕೊಡುವಂತಹ ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಅದು ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಅನ್ನ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಲೂಪಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ಡು ವೈಲ್ First, it will execute its set statements. Its statements andre now do while ge kodanta statements. Its statements once, then it checks the condition. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅದು ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಒಂದ್ಸ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಅನ್ನ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವಿದನ್ನ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಲೂಪಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಸೊ ದ ಡು ವೈಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಡು ವೈಲ್ ಸೊ ವೈಲ್ ಲೂಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡು ವೈಲ್ ಬೋತ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಬಟ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಸಿಚುಯೇಷನ್ಸ್ So based on the problem definition, we are select either while loop is suitable or do while loop is suitable. So based on the problem definition, we are select either while or do while loop. Clear? So in this do while loop, if the statements are repeatedly executed until the condition becomes true. Once the condition is false in the do while, the control is come out of the do while and execute the next statements in the program. In the do while statement, the set of statements executed repeatedly again and again until the condition is satisfied until the condition is satisfied means ನಮಗೆ ವೈಲ್ ಟ್ರೂ ಆದಾಗೆಲ್ಲ ರಿಪೀಟೆಡ್ ಆಗಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸಾರಿ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಟ್ರೂ ಆಗುತ್ತೋ ಅಷ್ಟು ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಒನ್ಸ್ ದ ವೈಲ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ವೈಲ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ದನ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡೂ ವೈಲ್ control come out of the do while loop and execute next statements and execute next statements in the program okay so this is the working procedure of the do while while we are called as a pre-tested do while we are called as a post-tested post tested in the value First it will check the condition, then it will execute the statement. In the do while, first it will execute its statements exactly once, then it will check the condition. In the do while, the while loop will be terminated, then the control is come out of the do while and execute the next statements in the program. So by using this walking procedure, now we are the flowchart syntax for the do while loop is first is initialization, later it will execute statement 1, statement 2, so on, statement n. Later we are at increment or decrement statement. Increment or decrement statement. Later it will set the condition. If test condition it will execute statement repeatedly. If it is false, control is come out of the loop and execute the next statements. So this is a flowchart syntax. Now I will write a programming syntax. Initialization statement, initialization statement, next here do, the program we are using, the keyword is do, the set of statements we are enclosed in a flower bracket, do statement 1, statement 2, so on, statement n, then write increment or decrement statement. Close it do and here give the while. In the while, we are given test condition. Semicolon. Next, after it will come out of the do while loop, it will execute the next statements in the code. So, this is the programming syntax for do while. See here, first we are initialize the value to the variable, looping variable. Later, do. What are the set of statements you want to be executed repeatedly? All the repeated statements we are enclosed in a pair of flower brackets. So, in the while loop, we are given a condition right here also. Once the do loop will be closed in the same line, after closing the flower bracket, we write the while loop. In the while loop, inside the parentheses, we are pause the condition. Later, the do while loop we are terminate here. अर्थ आयता इले सेमिकोलन टर्मिनेशन या पोस्ट टेस्ट लूपिंग स्टेटमेंट इन फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट एक्सिक्यूट आम कंडीशन चेक टर्मिनेट आयु टर्मिनेशन इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन द डू व्हाइल व्हाइल व्हेन द कंडीशन इज फॉल्स इट विल कम आउट ऑफ द लूप बट इन द डू व्हाइल द यूजर मस्ट शोस द टर्मिनेशन आफ्टर गिव द कंडीशन we must put the semicolon in the do while so this is very important when the do statements is completes we have close the flower bracket followed by the while loop followed by the condition condition by enclosed by semicolons followed by semicolon so this semicolon terminates the do while loop when the condition becomes false later outcome out of the do while then execute the next statements in the program clear Students, are you clear the syntax and the flowchart syntax? In the flowchart also, first we are initializing the variable value. So that value can be used to execute the statements once. After execute the statements, the variable value is incremented or decremented based on the problem definition. That incremented or decremented value is set the condition. If the condition is true, the control is go back to the do statements. If the condition is false, it will come out of the do while loop and execute the next statements in the program. Clear? Do while loop programs I will explain in the next class because it will take a lot of time. So completely we are see in the next class. Thank you, students.